we wanted to announce today that we are super excited to continue the work that we've been doing together, but doing it as a married couple.
WNBA star turned activist Maya Moore revealed that she has married Jonathan Irons, the wrongfully convicted man she helped free from prison after serving 23 years behind bars.
We got married a couple months ago, and we're excited to just continue this new chapter of life together.
The couple appeared on Good Morning America Wednesday to talk about their love story. The 31-year-old basketball pro said they met through a prison ministry program when she was 18 years old.
Over the last 13 years, we have just developed a friendship and just entered into this huge battle to get him home. And just over time, it was pretty clear what the Lord was doing in our hearts. And now we're sitting here today, starting a whole new chapter together.
Irons, who's now 40, recalled professing his love to her while he was still at Jefferson City Correctional Center in Missouri.
I wanted to marry her, but at the same time, protect her, because being in a relationship with a man in prison is extremely difficult and painful. And I didn't want her to feel trapped. And I wanted her to feel open and have the ability to anytime, if this is too much for you, go and find somebody to live your life, because this is hard.
After his release from prison in July, Irons didn't wait long to pop the question for real.
When I got out, we were in the hotel room. We had some friends in another room. It was winding down, and we were extremely tired, but we were still gassed up on excitement. And it was just me and her in the room, and I got down on my knees, and I looked up at her, and she kind of knew what was going on. I said, will you marry me? She said, yes. Here we are today.
Irons was tried and convicted as an adult when he was 16 years old by an all-white jury for the burglary and shooting at the home of 38-year-old Stanley Stotler. Irons maintained his innocence while he was in prison, saying he was wrongly identified during the lineup. After years of fighting, a Missouri judge overturned his conviction in March, saying there were problems with the way the case was investigated and tried, including a fingerprint report that would have proved his innocence not being turned over to his defense team. Now Moore and Irons are focused on spreading the word about local elections.
We're basically trying to just educate the public and, you know, and get them engaged in the voting process and just being more involved in, you know, what's going on with our country and our government and local jurisdictions, prosecuting offices.
Irons also explained that they hope to help others who have been wrongfully convicted.
That's hopefully something I can continue to do, and whatever else, you know, that Win with Justice can contribute to the fight, because it's a big fight, and the more hands involved makes the work easier. So we're doing our part.